We're in the Miksch family home. Today, we're going to be talking about what an 18th century Moravian like Henrietta Miksch would have known about light waves, how to harness them, how to use them. Light waves, as you may know, are part of the electromagnetic spectrum. Light waves that we're going to be talking about today are visible light waves, the part of the electromagnetic spectrum that we can see. Henrietta Miksch would have used the transparent glass to help her harness the light waves so that she can see as she is washing dishes. Now, transparent refers to matter through which light waves can easily pass. So as she's washing dishes, she can see the dirty stuff and scrub it off. And then she can see the rinse water to make sure her dish is nice and clean. Light waves move as transverse waves. And a transverse wave is a wave that moves the energy perpendicular to the motion of the wave. We can see that through surface ripples, like this. Why do we see color in bubbles? Well, let's talk about a way that light interacts with matter. Light waves are energy waves. Visible light is broken into different wavelengths that we know as color. So when those wavelengths of visible light are interacting with matter, the soap bubble, what happens is you have some wavelengths hitting the front of the soap bubble, some of them bouncing off the back of the soap bubble, and they interfere with one another, leading us to see all kinds of colors. Look at this kitchen. This is the type of kitchen that the Moravians would have lived in and used in the 18th century. You see how they've got a lot crammed into a small space. Here we have a vase of flowers cut from the garden outside. I want to show you something about the way light is interacting with matter in this vase of water and stem. So you have the light waves going from one medium, which is something that light can travel through, air, going into another medium, glass, and then going through another medium, water. What happens with all of that is when you go from one medium to another medium, the light waves are changing speed and they're bending. So it makes it look like these stems are bending. It's kind of a fun optical illusion. Here we are in the second room of the family house. It was called the stove room because this is where the stove is. The stove was banked from the kitchen fire and the heat would have radiated throughout this space. This is where the family slept, where they ate, where they did their work, and also where they ran a small shop selling things like ginger cakes and candles. Let's talk a little bit about how this punch tin lantern exemplifies some of the ways that light interacts with matter. Particularly, let's look at the actual punching of the tin, the holes in the tin. So what will happen is the light waves are attempting to escape, trying to get out of those holes. And when they are doing that, something very interesting happens, and it's called diffraction. Diffraction is when light waves hit matter and they try to go around it. They spread out around the item. And so what's happening is the light waves are hitting the tin and they're spreading out and going around those holes. Like the punch tin lantern, here's another item made of tin that would have held a candle. Light waves are hitting the matter, the tin butterfly, and they are reflecting that shape on the wall behind. Look, if I move the light source, it looks like the butterfly is flying. Another way we can talk about the Moravians, 18th century, and light interactions with matter has to do with this picture, and it's called an illumination. An illumination was often displayed at Christmas time. You can see here it is the Christmas nativity. You have a piece of translucent paper, such as oilcloth, that when placed in front of light, allows light to partially come through. This would have been something that Martha Elizabeth would have enjoyed, almost like a Christmas special. When the parents were telling her the story of the birth of Christ, they could have moved the light source around, illuminating various parts of the picture, almost making it look like a TV show today. Martha Elizabeth, who was a small child at the time that her family moved here to Salem, ends up growing up and marrying the doctor, Dr. Vierling. And she and Dr. Vierling have lots of children. One of those children is named Benjamin, and Benjamin becomes a shoemaker. Now, this interesting thing we have on the table is something called a shoemaker's lamp. A shoemaker's lamp is an apparatus that consists of glass globes filled with water, usually there would have been four, and a light source in the middle. First of all, the light waves moving from one medium, air, through another medium, glass, through another medium, water. You also have the diffraction, where when the light waves are trying to exit, they're spreading out, they're trying to move around. Then you have a puddle of light on the table. This is very helpful for occupations or trades like the shoemaker so that he can see what he's doing. This is the attic of the Miksch house. They would have used this space to store food crops as well as storage of items they didn't need downstairs. The attic space is dark because the materials used in constructing this part of the house are opaque. Opaque materials are things that do not allow light waves to travel through them. I hope you've enjoyed the tour of the Miksch family home today and our discussion of light waves. As we prepare to leave this edition of Exploratorium, I want to leave you with something that was found in the Moravian records dated December 4th, 1775. We must not leave unmentioned a most curious phenomenon which we saw on the evening of the 4th. In the twilight on the eastern horizon, there were great streams of fire from which fireballs shot south and west like cannonballs, separating as they fell. Brother Miksch and several brethren from Bethania were on the road returning from Cross Creek, and they saw this display. May all of us in our own times and places find this curious, phenomenal study of light to be an inspiring adventure. Thanks for joining us.